All right, what is going on? We are here with the Akai S950 all-around classic workhorse sampler. This is a sampler that does everything that you need and is a great starter sampler if you have an external MIDI keyboard or MIDI controller, anything that can play this thing, because obviously it's a rack mount. Now, the interesting thing that brought me to actually turn this on today is the live stream that we had this past weekend. And the conversation came up about the fact that newer samplers don't give you the option for polyphony or playing beyond an octave or two. Most new samplers come in some sort of groove box drum machine format that allows you to play, I don't know, a few notes and oftentimes no polyphony. So a great thing about these older samplers is they do accommodate for things like that. And we're just going to listen to the tonality of the S950 because one of the things that I really like about it is how it handles sounds as you pitch up and down, right? So we're just going to play around with that. And I'll play some patches so that you can hear what this sampler sounds like all on its own, but namely the fact that you can play chords, you can play octaves, you can do anything you want with this sampler, no problem. And it's a shame that most newer samplers don't allow you to do that. And it's my belief that just, you know, in general, I don't think that many people really care about that sort of thing today. But anyhow, we'll start with our regular sound. I did the old play something in front of the microphone. And here's what it sounds like coming out of the S950. So what I ended up doing was see if I could do it now. I put it to loop, which ended up with this. Right, so now we'll just play some patches. I have the S950 hooked up to the Insonic EPS 16 Plus. And while we're here, if you have an S950, are thinking about getting an S950 and don't know where to start, the Akai S950 operational manual is the most ideal, concise thing that you can get to get yourself up and running and give you a very sound working platform to start off with the S950. Yeah? So with that, let's get started on the sounds.
Thank you.
right, so we did a few things. We added some time stretch to it, and we also just put an envelope on the filter, just a couple simple things. But this sampler could take you a very long way, and any sampler in general, if you just use what it has. I exploited the pitch shifting, which is pretty unique to the S950, and pretty much all the Akai range that does that sort of thing, and also the analog filter. Nothing special, and you can get some pretty outlandish sounds just from any everyday regular sounds. And again, the pitching down with the S950 is amazing to me. Just the lower mid-range emphasis that you get is so good. And it's really something that I underestimated with Akai samplers. I generally disregarded them, didn't really think much of them until I really started digging into the older models, and the S950 definitely doesn't disappoint. But that is all I wanted to show for today. Remember to mark your calendars. December 5th is the release date of my new album, History Never Gets Old. I will catch you on the next one. In the meantime, please do take care of yourself. Peace.